Hello and welcome back to the second episode of Xenonauts 2, the short mini campaign. My name is Syken and today we're continuing our little gameplay demonstration of Xenonauts 2. If you haven't checked it out by now, there is an affiliate link in the comment section down below. If you like the game, consider buying it there and supporting the channel as part of it. You'll actually get it even cheaper than the normal price. Good. Off to the tactical mission. Today we're going to do a capture the resource mission, which is a second mission type, I would say, where we're actually needing to go in and start capturing individual resources. So speed will be of the essence here, and we are going to see how well our team is going to go about it. We got the Mars weapon platform with us for the first time. I decided to put a rifleman out and instead use the Mars platform. So let's see how well we will do with that $250,000 expensive platform. It better be worth its money. Hello and welcome back to the second installment of the mini mission or mini gameplay footage of Xenonauts 2. My name is Syken and today we're continuing our little campaign here to showcase the Xenonaut 2 gameplay. In the link down below, I want to remind you there is an affiliate link. If you like Xenonauts, it's a perfect option to grab the game for a little reduced price. Today's mission will be one of the collection missions, and this is another interesting game mission type. This second mission is always the similar one, so I've played through that mission already, but it is ultra difficult on the highest difficulty, because we're going to not only push into an enemy bastion fortress, but we also need to do it fast. And the way that we're going to do it is we're trying to collect 10 cleaner data items, which are basically computer files, so to speak, and then we need to run back to the airship. If we do that successfully, it'll be A-okay, and we get 25,000 for every additional file that we're getting. Reminder, money is hard to get by, so it's actually quite rare that you get that much money. So we're fighting for the first time against the cleaners. Don't underestimate these guys. They're actually quite difficult, and one of the reasons that makes them so difficult is they have a lot of firepower at their disposal. We're using our platform. Oh yeah. The Mars platform. Luckily with 100 hit points, we're looking absolutely unbothered. And we're just removing all of this unnecessary clutter here. Whilst we're at it, let's begin to move out into cover. Oh, taking a couple of shots there. And firing back, suppressing one of them. You can also see there is another guy right over there. Don't like it. So our shield will move in to the truck. Oh, we got even more enemies. All right. This is crazy. I've never had that many enemies in the first iteration. That indeed is absolutely wild. Moving into cover. Hunkering down. And I think the only way to deal with this is a good old grenade. Very good. So, grenade launcher worked out well. You can already see kind of the name of the game will be use explosives liberally. There is no Dr. Valen telling you you might want to restrain yourself with explosives. Anchor down. And shotgun to the face works like a charm. We got not enough to let that go. 23. Before we're doing that, I would like to use our snipers. Call the telephone joker, if you so want. Not a great odd. I don't like it. By the way, you can always see the odds on the top, on the bottom right corner. So 60% accuracy. We're having armor, which makes it 55, and a tactical module, so around 60%. High accuracy shot multiplies that by 1.35. And then we do have cover in the way, which is the 40% reduction, and then the next cover doesn't count, but then we do have the smoke in the way, which unfortunately stacks, so well, that is not optimal. Moving to here. Oh, taking a shot, that's not good. Anchor down. We know there is another guy. And in case of doubt, use the explosive. Another grenade clears out that mess. So, moving over here. And all the way to here. We know that there is one guy here. Off we go. Can't hit him there. If we move to here, how's this looking? Still bad. 41, not good. Ugh, that's even worse. Could put ourselves to over here for better aiming angles. Okay, well, not perfect. I don't like it. Do we have a grenade? No, we don't. Good. Those soldiers that we are done with, we could ignore them. Instead, we do have two snipers. And my question for you would be, where do we want to position ourselves? This is a decent position. We could also move the sniper all the way up to here to then have really good aiming angles. I don't like rushing in with the sniper, but that's okay, as we're removing the rest of the building. I hate this bus, by the way. Super good cover. Now we're going to go to here. And we're switching to the pistol so that we at least have two overwatch shots. And that's really the end of the round. We're going to take some beating. Let's hope it's not going to be too bad. Uh-oh. Well, it's pretty bad. Took a lot of shots, and we definitely will need to heal ourselves. You can see we're down to half hit points. But we got ourselves up to 43 again, which is pretty good. The armor definitely helps a ton on these missions. Removing his cover, and then we're going to take a sniper shot. Just a little bit cover in the way, but that is fine. There we go. Problem solved. Continuing to move in with our shield. Okay, we're looking good. The Mars weapon platform moves forward as well. That's our sniper, and that is our grenadier. I think having the grenadier a bit further forward will be helpful. This turn is really all about getting in position. These are already the first computers that we need. Sniper is here. Second assault doesn't look too hot, but we unfortunately need to still push forward. So, I don't know. Let's give him some full cover here. Assault rifle soldier will take over. Good, we got a sniper on each side. Heavy weapons person. Yep, moves forward into cover. Bunker down. Sniper is right here. I think we're looking good. Good, the core question is if we're breaching. Yeah, we want to breach from here still. Could a smoke grenade help us in any shape or form? Potentially not. Potentially we're good the way we are. Turn number two. Done. There we go. Sniper is ready. Ooh. Alright. Well, I can already tell you this is not going to go well for you guys. Cover blown. Oh, and we don't have another shot. Well, 11. Yeah, that's two shots. Okay. Pistol. And done. Very good. Sometimes you just gotta be persistent. One, two. Okay. Gotta remove those walls. Opens the door here. One, two. Items captured. All right. Moving on over. Opening really more vision range than anything. Okay, that allows us a nice straight up line to look into anything on that left hand side. Great, that's exactly what we wanted. Moving in on the other side. I would love to grab that middle console. In the meantime, our breach team here is not having so much luck. We will, but that's the weak side that we're playing. Have to wonder. Could switch sides here and then essentially have the heavy gunner to support on the other side. It's not great. We need a few more data pieces. There's likely data over here. We got 1, 2 inside, 3 inside, and we need to push in deep. Got 2 more of these wonderful rockets, and that will be it. So this opening here is great. It'll give us all the time and distance that we need for the snipers. In the meantime, we're moving up, really just supporting that other flank. Okay, we're just going to wait. I'll grab the data next turn. We got high ground over here. Would that be helpful to go to here and then just shoot downstairs? I mean, why not? Excuse me. But we could move to here. There is some fight in the inner sector. We should be good. Slightly better aiming position here, because now we can shoot all the way in there. Okay, lots and lots of enemies. Oh, this guy's helping us. He only has a pistol. He seems to be on our side. Moving in. Seeing a lot of enemies here. Good. One of them immediately down. And Mars is pushing forward. Interesting, we got more data. Oh, I see, okay. Good, we got a lot of data. We just need to make sure that we're not being overrun on this side. Sniper shouldn't go in with just a pistol. I would rather want to make sure that we're not being targeted from the side here. Yep, that was a smart move. Slightly back, we're going to go forward and then take on this guy next turn. Alright, no one here. This is number 9 and number 10. We could almost be out of here. supporting this side with our shield. That's not bad. I'm not too worried about the Mars. Could go for the pistol shot. Oh wow. Oh, not good. Too far away, unfortunately. Good, I want to explode that back here. Perfect. Down. Hunker. And we're definitely going to shoot next round. Okay. Alright, there's another tango right up there. Unfortunately, our flank didn't only not work out, but we very much got ourselves killed up there. Not good, but like I mentioned, life is cheap in Xenonauts. Okay, very good. I think that's good enough. Really a big fan of rolling the dice here. This guy is bleeding, and we're in a safe spot. Okay, we could definitely hit this guy. Even better without the cover. Switching to our normal gun, and we're using a straight shot. Unfortunately, a miss. Good, sniper just stays where they are at. sniper moves up. Anchor is down, and let's try that. There we go. Distance sometimes can be helpful. Opening another door. One down. Shield moves in, and I think we're just going to pepper with normal shots. Come on. Alright, well, that was clearly not a good technique. Okay, well, at least we suppressed him. That means worse aim for him going forward. Oh, this is an overwatch. We're done, we're done. Slightly moving forward, but elsewise we're done. I still need one, two pieces of data. And there is only one more enemy over here. So grabbing that and that will help us to finish the mission. Yeah, end of turn. There we go, sniper overwatch. Good, more reinforcements are coming. We need to get back to the chopper, as they say. Moving in, grabbing the data. Moving in, grabbing the data. And then, moving, moving, moving. Triplet shot into rush out. And what we want to do is get out of here as quick as possible. Snipers. Begin to quietly retreat. In the midst of all of that, we are continuing to move out. Moved, moved, moved. Our shield operative moves. Why not? Yep. Keep them honest. Good, our explosives are gone, but this guy is heavily, heavily injured. And I think we got everything. Now, let's wait for the reinforcements. Good, this guy just died from bleeding out. rush back to the Sky Ranger. Move in. And we continue to move. Mars weapon platform begins to move as well. Super good weapon platform, by the way. Totally like what I'm seeing here. Good. We're going to heal. There you go. Into the Sky Ranger. And we're almost done. Okay, good. Very good. Mission complete. We unfortunately lost a soldier on our way, but yeah, that is part of the situation at the beginning. Every single agent that we fought against did have higher stats and automatic weapons and a little bit more hit points than our soldiers had. Plus, I think we fought, I have lost count, but I think we fought something around 20-ish, so a 2-to-1 ratio. And there is no such thing as just taking multiple shots, unless you are kind of behind cover, pretty far away out of weapon range where there is a damage fall off, then of course it could happen. But other than that, not really happening. Unfortunately, Midoriando didn't make it, but we got two little medals here. Plus one to all attributes, and they have suffered more than 30 hit point damage. Well, that he certainly did. And soldier will be granted the crux if they eliminated four or more units in a single battle. Yep, the Grenadier actually worked out very well. And we got ourselves 10 cleaner data. Commander, good work recovering all of the data. I'm still sifting through it, but it looks very much royal enough. Lose leads to begin unraveling the entire cleaner control network. Bad news is, it's a lot harder than I expected. Realistically, we need to assume these agents have been subverting and are fully under alien control. Although digging into classified entities isn't exactly easy, it seems to suggest we're dealing with potentially thousands of cleaners. Okay. Structure ensures captured agents cannot be compromised in a wider region. We don't know the exact location of the regional command cells, but ultimately our goal is to find the headquarters. Well, sounds a lot like an agent's nightmare. And here you can see we've now finished the alien magnetic weapons, which is our very first upgrade, going for Warden Armor. And as you can appreciate, what we're definitely wanting to do is we're wanting to start production of a few of these beautiful weapons. Sniper rifles in particular are very good. We might want to go for one assault rifle. And yeah, maybe one shotgun. I gotta be really careful. These things are damn expensive. The other thing that I will say is the Mars Combat Platform was worth every single dollar that we have gotten so far. So that's good. And here it says clean a network progress. So that's going to be like the first real task for the Xenonauts to go through the cleaner's network. Looking a little bit at the time from a gameplay mechanic, I think we have covered most of the basics for Xenonauts 2. You can see that now soldiers will need to recover. They've taken hit point damage, but overall you can also see that the stats are slowly but surely increasing. The one thing that I haven't covered so far is the ranking system. As soldiers begin to rank up, they give a bonus to bravery to all of the soldiers, but only the highest soldier kind of gives that bonus to everyone in the team. So realistically, you want to have high ranking soldiers, and you also want to make sure that they come with really good stats attached from the get-go. So that's kind of the perfect scenario that you're dealing with. At the beginning of the game, all of the soldiers will be really crappy. Over time, with more missions under their belt, you can imagine they always get like plus one to all of the stats. So over time, they will become more and more potent, then reach towards the 100 mark on most of the stats. Then with higher armor, you can at least withstand a couple of shots. So that's really the progression system. I won't go too much into reviewing it. That is a different video. But yeah, that's what you get out of Xenonauts. My last request to you would be, if you feel strongly about the game and really want to see it on the channel, if you like to see a little bit more kind of realistic take on the whole XCOM genre, then this could be your chance. I'm open for Xenonauts 2. It's an interesting game. It certainly has the necessary difficulty that we're all looking for, and it could be a good playthrough, or at least kind of a, say, 20 mission-ish let's play. We can see how far we can get into the game. Could play 100 days of Xenonauts and see just how far we can get in 100-150 days of Xenonauts. And that's just a let's play. So there are a couple of options. I'll leave it up to you to let me know which ones you prefer. For now, thank you so much. Out of the world of Xenonauts, I'll say a goodbye and see you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.